Hey, good morning everyone and welcome to your channel Learn Data Science with Pranjal. In this knowledge video, I will discuss a technique for outlier detection, that is your ecliptic envelope. So in my earlier knowledge videos, I have already discussed the two different techniques for outlier detection and removal, and those were your box plot and using your standard deviation. But in this knowledge video, I would specifically focus on outlier detection using ecliptic envelope. So let's first see what ecliptic envelope actually means, and then we will see how to use that algorithm for removing our outliers. So as the name Eclipse suggests, in Eclipse you have two axes. One is your major axis and another one is your minor axis. So in this diagram, I have just created for the representational purposes. Over here you can see two types of observations. One is marked in green and another one is marked in red. And this, all the green and the red observations are coming in the larger space, that is your in the square bracket. But if I consider one eclipse, then probably all the red points seems to be an outlier. And the same type of technique I would be using in my coding to detect the outliers. So let's first create a model where we actually have the outliers, and then probably let's see how to remove those outliers. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take one data set, that is our insurance data set. And in this insurance data set, I will build a linear regression model. So in interest of saving the time, what I've done is I've already written a certain piece of code. Let me quickly go through the code. And in this initial part, I'll not tell that how the linear regression and all those things is being built. That is my assumption, that people know how to build my linear regression and how to remove the null values and how to handle the data. But let's still quickly discuss this thing. So I have done my necessary import, NumPy, pandas, seaborn, all those things. And this is my data set. So over here, my target variable is charges. So I have to predict the insurance charges of the patient who are getting admitted to the hospital. And at line number 4, I'm doing my data preparation. I'm converting everything into numbers. So some of the data, for example, your sex, smoker, region, all these columns were in non-numeric, so I'm converting them into numbers. Then at line number 5, what I'm doing is I am doing my train test split. At line number 6, I'm dividing my data into X and Y. So all the data cleaning part is being done. And then I am building my linear regression model. So I'm also scoring my model. The score seems to be quite good, 0.75, which is nothing but your R square. So R square is good. And then I am doing my prediction at line number 29. And at line number 30, what I am doing is I am creating one data frame. And in this data frame, what I am doing is I am having two columns. One is your actual column and another one is your predicted column. So I am saying predicted, comma, actual things. And then I am saying I am finding my error. So error is nothing but your actual minus predicted. So after finding my error, what I'm doing, I'm trying to check the certain assumptions of my linear regression. So there are a number of assumptions we make in our linear regression. So first thing I'm checking is the mean of my error term, so which should be close to zero. So this seems to be close to zero. It is E minus 12. So that is your, after a decimal, you have 12 zeros, so which is close to zero. And I am plotting the histogram. From this histogram, definitely I can say that I have the problem of extreme values, or you can say outliers, because this histogram seems to be heavily right skewed. So probably mean would be definitely greater than your median. And then to check it further, I'm also doing my kind of scatter plot of my error terms. And from this plot also, I can see that there seems to be, in a way, outliers are there, because when the X is increasing, then your error terms are increasing. Then I'm doing my regression plot. So in this regression plot, I see that there are patterns in my error terms. So for better understanding, I have taken a snippet of my regression plot and taken it over on the paint window so that I can use my brush. So over here, if I encircle some values, so values something like these. So these things may be my outliers. My outliers may be these values. I may be having outliers something like this. So these seems to be kind of outliers, and few outliers over here. So the regions which I have marked in red probably seems to be my outlier. But now what I'll do is, instead of using my box plot or my standard deviation thing. I will use my eclipse method, because over here the outliers are not in one direction, but I can see that they are taking a kind of cone shape, or they are taking, in a way, they may be taking a eclipse shape. So if we draw an imaginary eclipse, something like this, let me try drawing it with some different color, with a green color. Let's quickly discuss that. So I have drawn an imaginary kind of eclipse, this green eclipse. So probably the values in this region probably may be the values which are okay values, which are not outliers, and the values which are beyond this eclipse probably may be taken as my outliers. So now let's see how to remove these outliers. So for removing the outliers, first of all, what we need to do is we need to convert our data frame, that is a predicted and actual, which we have created in our previous step. I will convert it into an array format, because the input, the next time which I give the input, it should be in array format. And now what I'm doing is from sklearn.covariance importing ecliptic envelope. So this is the function which I would be using to find my outliers. And then I am saying ELP envelope, ecliptic envelope containment equal to 0.05. So this containment equal to 0.05, this is an optional parameter. Even if you don't give it, your model will still work. And the documentation says the amount of outliers you want to find out. So if you don't give anything, the default is 0.1. 0.1 means 10%. So it will find 10% of the outlier. Over here, what I've given is, I have set only 0.05, which is nothing but your 5%. So I'm saying I don't want to remove very strict on the outliers. I just want to remove the 5%. Only those extreme values I wish to remove it. Now what I do is, I do my prediction. So in this function, when you use ecliptic envelope, the output is your 1 and minus 1. 1 and minus 1. So minus 1 means it is an outlier, and 1 means it's not an outlier. So I am having around 54 outliers. Let me quickly check the shape of x. So x dot shape. So shape is 1070, and if you take the 5% of it, probably you will get 54% of the data. 54 records would be taken as my outliers. So in this predicted, you would be having either 1 or minus 1. For each and every record in your data frame, you will have either 1 or minus 1. Minus 1 indicates it's an outlier, and 1 indicates it's not an outlier. And based upon your contamination percent, it will give you the outlier. Since I have given 0.05, it is giving me the 5% of the outlier. Now what I'm doing is, I want to remove those outliers. So for removing the outliers, first of it has till now it has given me the output in terms of minus 1 and plus 1. But to find exactly remove the outliers, I need to know the position. So I'm saying np.where and predicted equal to minus 1. So I'm filtering out index position for all the outliers. So this is the index position. And now what I'm doing is, I'm using that index position. I'm using that index position, and I get the outliers. So these are my outliers. So actual values and the predicted values. Now I do a second plot to show it how the outliers, or how, or basically how my outlier, this function is working. So I'm saying plt.plot x0 and x1. So I'm taking my actual and predicted values and marking them as color as red. And then I'm saying plt.plot outlier values, color as blue. So the blue values over here are indicating my outliers, and the red values are indicating your normal values. And from this curve also, we can see that this red values are probably in kind of eclipse, are in kind of eclipse. So keep one thing in mind, that I have taken red as a normal values and blue as my outlier values. So I have taken this snippet on the paint window, and if we see that, and over here I have drawn an eclipse in a black color eclipse, and we can see that all the values which are beyond the eclipse are probably taken as my outliers. So it's also a very good method to find the outliers, but we need to keep one thing in mind, that it should not be the first choice to use the eclipse for finding or removing the outliers. We should still try going for a box plot and standard deviation method. But if you think, or if you see or foresee that your data is, instead of being normally distributed, it is also taking a kind of cone pattern, or a kind of eclipse pattern, then only this eclipse method should be used. Otherwise, the best method to remove your outliers would still be your box plot and your standard deviation method. So this brings us to the end of this knowledge video, and I hope people would enjoy this video. Thank you everyone for watching this video. Hope to see you soon in my next video. Till that time, happy learning.